as you can see, it is a match that matters so much, so very much. Barnsley named the same side that saw off Huddersfield, so Paul Hayes is again preferred to Chris Shuker. Paul Heckingbottom won this final last year with Sheffield Wednesday. Martin Devaney scored in the playoff final here for Cheltenham, but Bobby Hassel was a loser here with Mansfield. Both strikers, Mark Richards and Danny Nardiello, had loan spells at Swansea once upon a time. Fit again, Neil Austin makes the bench. Swansea are also unchanged, so top scorer Lee Trundle is again on the bench as Kenny Jackett sticks with his little and large strike force. Leon Knight scored a playoff final winner here for Brighton 2 years ago. Rory Fallon started his career at Barnsley. Gary Monk and Kevin Austin are also former Barnsley players. So too is sub Tommy Williams, once a loser in this final with QPR. Fit again, Kevin McLeod is another sub.
Barnsley will start 4-4-2. They're a team who like to play from the back, and in Reid and Kay, they've got two centre-halves capable of doing that. The full-backs, Heckingbottom and Hassel, two attack-minded full-backs, love to join in further up the pitch. Midfield, McPhail, he's the man they want on the ball, the creative element. Howard will complement him, he'll get box-to-box for them. And they're strong in wide areas. Devaney, his pace and trickery causes all sorts of problems. Hayes, he can play up front, so I'm sure we'll see him joining in with Richards, the target man, and the intelligence and pace of Nardiello up front. Swansea also play 4-4-2, and again, a team who like to play from the back. Monk and Austin do take no nonsense at the back, but they're capable of bringing the ball out. Ricketts will attack for 90 minutes if he can. They've got the class of Tait at right back. And in wide areas again, Britton, the pace and trickery, work rate from him. Robinson, 17 goals this season, he'll try and join him further up. Tudor Jones will play the holding role. O'Leary, he'll be the one who will try and stop McPhail playing. And up front, Fallon, terrific target man, and you'll be looking to see Leon Knight, with his pace and intelligence, trying to play off him.
Well, Kenny Jackett is hoping to secure back-to-back promotions for Swansea City, who've brought around 35,000 fans along the M4 to Cardiff. They're a big club, all right, who would not be out of place in the Championship. But so too are Barnsley, who've brought over 20,000 here today. Swansea supporters are loud and proud, but then Barnsley are from Yorkshire, and they've always done passion pretty well in that county. There are some big clubs in the Championship next season. Leeds, Birmingham, West Brom, Wolves, Sunderland, Southampton, Norwich, Ipswich, Leicester, Coventry, Derby, Palace, and so on. Barnsley and Swansea would just love some of that. Lee Mason is the man in charge. This is high stakes football, very high stakes, and Barnsley looking for a very early opening. But Andy Robinson and now Sam Ricketts have it on this left hand side for Swansea. Up towards Rory Fallon, first flick on for Leon Knight, and here's Paul Reid, the Barnsley captain.
I think it's important that Reid and Kay get the grips with Fallon early on in the semi-final. Andy Booth caused no end of problems, especially in the first leg at Barnsley. Barnsley problems at the moment.
Reid won it. Oh, and Sam Ricketts took out Devaney, but Lee Mason's wave play on. It's Nardiello, who does not make the most of it.
Well, that was a strange advantage played by Lee Mason there. Everybody stopped. They weren't aware it was happening. Well, I'm surprised Ricketts didn't get booked here. You see Devaney's pace just get past him. That's premeditated. That's a yellow card for me. He goes to blow his whistle, then he waves play on. Everybody stopped. Nardiello, it's a long way out. Not far off. I think Swansea would have been absolutely devastated had that gone in. He sat on the bench, but having a giggle there with his mate.
is Anthony Kay. Nardiello jostling with his former Old Trafford pal Tait. Robinson has run into trouble. And Barnsley are bursting towards goal. Oh, and Gary with a magnificent save to push that effort past the post.
Well, they're just getting a little bit of a tangle in midfield. Lose possession, Howard onto it in a flash. You just back off him a little bit, takes it, and you think Gary just pulled it in the bottom corner, gets his little bit of luck, goes the wrong way at first, does well to get back across, and how close is that? Just takes the paint off the post.
In a playoff final in the year 2000 when they lost to Ipswich at Wembley, lost out on a Premiership return in the process. Hassel. Nardiello. Richards. Devaney. And Kevin Austin got it away, but Hayes comes in! And Barnsley have the lead! Paul Hayes has his sight set on the championship.
Well, he's not been involved in the game very much, but he certainly has now. And how to make your mark in a playoff final. We know he can play up front, he's been playing the wide left, but we see the ball played to Devaney, and a lot of space, they don't close him down, quick enough, one touch, two touch, puts it in there, you think Austin's dealt with it reasonably well, nobody's picking him up, doesn't get a clean strike, doesn't matter, you hit the target, you've got a good chance, and this is exactly what he does, hits it into the ground, maybe he should have done better, Gary, at the near post, he won't be happy with that, comes through the legs of Tait, but Dicky Bird, he's delighted, by the way. So he should be. Three spot on.
Mark Richards, who lost two playoff semi-finals with Northampton. That's unlucky. Knight, Robinson. Can Swansea respond? Ricketts is waiting to receive. Ricketts in towards Fallon. Now Tudor Jones. They are hanging in there. Ricketts! That flashes wide.
Well, how intelligent is this, by the way? That catches everybody by surprise. He's put one ball in there, it comes out to him again, and you think, well, here we go again, he's going to put another one in there. But no, spots a gap there. I think if that is the target, Colgan's beaten. Intelligent thinking there. Goes wide, but the idea was good.
Austin, Fallon, Annie, Leon Knight is offside. Not going to count, doesn't go in anyway, the flag is up.
Well, did that flag go up late? Looked straight across at the linesman when it went through, there was a bit of a mistake here. Fallon flicks it up and he's onside there. And there was a mistake here. Well, I think that's unlucky, he didn't score. But they've been done a little bit there, Swansea. And he thinks so as well.
I think he knew, but the decision went against him. Popped back by Austin, here's Hayes, the goal scorer.
It's noticeable again that Fallon, he's the target all the time, but when it's in an area like he is now, halfway inside the opponent's half, they seem to drop off him a little bit, let him flick it on. See it again here, look. But this time he holds it up. Thinking by Andy Ritchie.
Ricketts. Robinson nearby. Ricketts won't use him. And again, he's gone close, Sam Ricketts.
Well, I'll be surprised if they lose this, that we don't see Ricketts play at a higher level. Very impressed with him so far. Said he likes to get forward, but when he's got the ball at his feet, he can do the business. Nearly catches him out again at the near post, Colgan. The only thing in his mind, he's going to run at players. Not the best of strikes, but it's a great ability on the ball. Good balance. Terrific outlet for Swansea. This is where they will have to work against Fallon, because they cannot back off him here. I'm surprised they don't stick somebody in front of him. One behind, one in front, so it nullifies the threat.
Go Harry Monk towards Tudor Jones. Fallon! Spectacular! Rory Fallon, who started his career at Barnsley, scores a glorious goal against them. It is 1-1.
Well, you won't see a better finish than that. The technique was spot on. You maybe expect Leon Knight to do that, but the big fella, he's done well. Well-worked free kick, and they kept it away from Fallon this time. There he is, just behind. Technique, brilliant. You don't stop that. They keep it away from him. It's one well there. Look at that, the perfect technique. Textbook stuff. Concentration, brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Doesn't he know it? Back. I was going to say he's good going forward, but he will work to get back and help out.
Hayes corner, Gere can't get too near it. It's off the line. Frantic, and I think it was Fallon who cleared it off the line.
It was Fallon who cleared it off the line. And that's the benefit of having somebody like him back there helping out. Gere doesn't get it, not a foul. Intelligent head back, and there's Fallon, three on the line, but it's him who gets it off the line. And what a valuable player he is.
Fallon doing his bit at both ends. Hassel charging in, and there's Fallon again to boot it away.
Well, I said I was impressed with the response from Swansea. You've got to be impressed with the way Barnsley reacted to conceding the equaliser. Can't catch your breath at the moment.
Leon Britton's going to latch onto this. Swansea allowed to keep going. Leon Knight, foul, right on the edge of the area by Anthony Kay.
I think Anthony Kay saying, well, I'm allowed to stand up and he's allowed to run into me. Be interesting to see what happened. He just checks inside. Yeah, takes his ankle out. Can have no qualms about that.
Thieves together at Barnsley.
No mates out there. Did he go down a little bit easy? He played a little bit for that. Fallon. Shouldn't he? In a good area again, similar to where they scored from.
Robinson struck it well. Oh, terrible mistake from Nick Colgan. And Robinson relishes the moment. And Swansea have turned it around just like that.
Well, he wouldn't have been dreaming about a moment like that, Colgan. He was superb in the semi-finals against Huddersfield. They took a quick free kick. Rory Fallon didn't even see it taken. He was the man who was fouled. He's got to recover from that. He's got to get the backing of his teammates. You see it taken early. Fallon with his back to the play there, but Robinson's not worried. Takes it in. Not the greatest, but what is he doing there? Got nothing behind it at all. I don't think he moved a great deal. Just didn't get his body position as he wanted. And you hate these sort of bloomers. This could cost them the championship. He's over the moon with it, but sure, Andy Ritchie isn't.
Well, it's a real howler. O'Leary has been around at Swansea for a long, long time, through the bad times. Robinson again, and this time Colgan somehow stops it right on the line and fends off a challenge from Knight.
Well, he atones there, Colgan. Knight seemed to go down as if he's been hit by the truck. Could that be a pivotal moment? I'd like to see this again. He's been booked.
Yellow card for Bobby Hassel.
Well, it's headed back, lovely technique again, goes through legs and he atones there. And Hassel not very happy, just throws him to the ground, gets his arm across him, great strike. Nearly gets through him, but that could be a pivotal save. I don't think there's too much in that. Saw it late, but didn't he do well? Stops it from Knight. I think Hassel thought Knight had gone through Colgan. Colgan, not a problem with him, and it's a bit rash by Bobby Hassel.
Hecking bottom. Proper Yorkshire name, that.
Certainly is.
Reed. Devaney. Tudor Jones has released Robinson. Swansea on the prowl again. Robinson, can he shake off Devaney? Robinson delivers, Fallon, Leon Knight! And what a big challenge from Reed. And then Britton
fires over.
Well, it's the three men involved there. Robinson starts it off. Look at Robinson, how well he does against Devaney here. Holds him off, he's strong. Gets his cross in, and Fallon does ever so well. Puts it down, but look at Reed. Reads the situation so well. Follow-up's not very good from Britain, but look at Fallon. Awareness. He thinks he's going to put it in an empty net. The captain's having none of that.
The field inspired by a Leon Knight hat-trick. Set them up for the playoffs rather nicely.
And when you've got strikers like them, you know you've always got a chance.
McPhail in towards Nardiello. He's held off Austin. Free kick. And it's in a similar position to where Swansea had one in the first half. Howard, the man down.
First real surge they've had, Barnsley, for quite a while. Strong there, does well Nardiello. Just trips him there, just a little trip. It's a definite trip. It's the first bit of bright play they've had this second half. Sticks the leg out. And obliges by falling over it.
Well, then Howard, who started his career at Southampton, and, well, could be hoping to go back there next year in the Championship. But Barnsley are going to need some inspiration from this free kick. They couldn't have asked for much better an opportunity than this.
The thing is, when it's so close, if you want to strike on goal, you're right in the 18-yard box. It's very difficult to lift it quickly over the wall. And it's a big wall. We've got big players in there. And get it to dip. That's the problem they've got. Look at the size of the people in the wall there. Four big men in there. If you're going to get that up and over and stick it in the top corner, you've got to be world-class.
Danny Nardiello, groomed by Manchester United, had a loan spell at Swansea a couple of years ago. Setting himself for this. Nardiello finds a way through! Barnsley, by back, Danny Nardiello! Makes it 2-2!
Well, there has to be something wrong with that wall. It's a big wall, but it's not a very safe wall. Has gone right down the side. He didn't bend it over the top. He just put it down the side. And Gerrard just stood there, flat-footed.
And he wouldn't want to be a goalkeeper at that end in this game. After Nick Colgan and now Willie Gerrard.
Well, look at this. How much space has he got to just put it past there? There's got to be questions asked there about the wall. Surely just flat-footed, it's come through. It's not the greatest strike in the world, but it's on target. Just goes past everybody. It's the softest free kick you'll ever see in your life.
This League One playoff final takes yet another twist. Barnsley level it. And Gerrard trying to explain what went on there, but he was certainly wrong-footed by Nardiello's free kick.
Well, okay.
Nardiello's flick. Hayes sets it up for Devaney. Right in the middle, and Reid coming in! Oh! It's bounced away from goal, but Paul Reid almost made the ultimate captain's contribution.
He's done too much with it, hasn't he? Just try to head it down like you're told to in the textbook. Oh, he goes right. Got the right area, does everything right, but just gets too much into the ground with the header. You just don't think he's going to bounce right over, but that's a gilt-edged chance. Andy Ritchie knows that. You'd have fancied him 10 out of 10 on the training pitch to put that in the net.
Ricketts will take it. O'Leary. Tate. Trundle. Britton has gone ahead of him. And Trundle has found him. And Britton has picked out Alan Tate. He could win it for Swansea.
Didn't he know he could win it for Swansea as well? A total adrenaline rush. Trundle does well and Britton does very well. Awareness. He gets his first touch well. You think he's going to blast it, but he just tries to take the whole net and the goalkeeper with him. First touch, not bad. You think just hit the target and he hits nowhere near. Oh, look at Kenny Jacket. He knows how close he's come to the Championship. He's a different threat again. Fresh pair of legs and tired minds, tired bodies at the back. Could be a big bonus for Swansea.
Akinfenwa Certainly looking lively, as you would expect. Akinfenwa! Within inches of making an incredible immediate impact.
He certainly did, but I thought there was a touch of handball there, and so did Reid. They back off him, they allow him to turn. Robinson's made a good run, he goes by himself, drags it the other way, and again just shaves the post. See, it's bobbling all over the place. That hits the target. Colgan has no chance.
Not really going to attract Shuka that, don't care, right? Have to be wary.
I just feel it's one of the substitutes who's going to have a big part of playing. A goal that gets to come. Fresh legs out there, bit of pace, bit of something different.
Trundle, he's got past Kay. Oh, he's still going. It's Lee Trundle. No!
Well, it was made for him, wasn't it? Everything right but the finish, the icing on the cake. He knows when he gets in the box that they can't touch him. You think he's going to have a go with his right, comes in, delays, hits the target, probably wins the game. Strength, power, determination, gets away from Kay. You think just hit the target, just at full stretch, doesn't do it. How close is that again for Kenny Jackett?
30 extra minutes almost up. We hear there is going to be another minute added on.
Robinson.
Devaney. It's a corner for Barnsley. Last chance to win it, surely. An enthralling end to an exciting and entertaining game, and if Barnsley score here, they're in the championship. The Barnsley fans gathered at that end, hoping, praying. Devaney lobs it in, but Guéret gets to grips with it. There might just be one time for a last Swansea assault. Leon Britton. Trundle. Britton again, and now Paul Reid. And we are going to have penalties to decide who wins promotion to the Championship after 46 grueling league matches, after two legs of a torturous semi-final, and after 120 minutes here. It's all going to come down to whose day it is.
Adams is a confident young man.
Prepare yourself for the drama, the suspense and the tension of a penalty shooter. Swansea's cult hero is first up, Lee Trundle. Trundle finds the bottom corner perfectly.
Duncan better than that, right in the side netting. They say big men stand up when the need is there. Look at this for a penalty. You don't stop them. It's a great dive as well. He nearly got to it, but that is perfection from a penalty spot.
Trundle gets Swansea on their way. And Paul Hayes, who opened the scoring at the Millennium Stadium this afternoon, is going to be Barnsley's first penalty taker.
Well, he scored at Huddersfield. Very confident penalty.
And Swansea fans at that end. Here comes Hayes. And that was pretty cool too, by the way.
Well, he did exactly the same at Huddersfield. You think, well, that's confidence for you. And that certainly was terrific, Tait. If he misses it, he looks a clown. He doesn't miss it, though.
I'm sure there'll be some wobbly legs walking up to take these penalties, and Leon Britton is next for Swansea.
There's some wobbly legs up here.
Colgan trying to make himself big. Leon Britton. Right in the corner again, the opposite side of Trundle.
Well, he didn't take a long run up. And maybe not the cleanest stroke, but did the job. Steve Claridge was saying, hit the target. It's what he does. Bubbles once, but again, right in that side netting.
100% so far, and Chris Shuka is next to face this arduous, tortuous task. Shuka keeps his cool and sends Guerre the wrong way, and nobody is slipping up yet.
I tell you what, the confidence with which those four penalties have been taken is staggering. The atmosphere in this stadium, your nerves must be jangling. Tremendous penalty.
Adebayo Akinfenwa, who scored the goal that won the Football League trophy for Swansea here, steps forward. He is the next man on the spot. And we mean on the spot. Akinfenwa. Oh, he's missed it. It's over and out from Akinfenwa. It's advantage Barnsley in the shootout.
Well, that's what I say. You try and be clever. You can be a hero or you can be a dud. And look at him, tries to be clever, leaning back, points it over the top, and that'll come back to haunt him. Just step up and strike it, hit the target, don't try and be clever.
Heckingbottom next to endure the agony. Every kick counts, every kick means so much. Heckingbottom scores, and Barnsley are 3-2 up in the shootout.
Yeah. Total confidence there. Under so much pressure from the Swansea fans. It's at their end, the pens are being taken. Look at this. Centre keeper. He went down a bit early there, Gary. Disappointed with himself, but confident strike.
The pressure now falls on Owen Tudor Jones. Came from non-league football a couple of years ago. Proved to be a terrific signing for Kenny Jackett. It's Tudor Jones, he scores to keep Swansea's hopes alive.
Well, that's what you do, you step up, you don't try and just sidestep or try and outwit the goalkeeper, just step up and hit the back of the net.
Anthony Kay, Barnsley born, used to support the team as a boy at Oakwell.
Well, a brave centre-half stepping up here. Is he just going to blast it? I would if I were him.
Here comes the boy from Barnsley, and he scores superbly for Barnsley, and Swansea have got to score their next penalty.
Cool as you like. The pressure's so intense out there. Just staggering now, they're holding the nerve. No panic, sends Guerre the wrong way yet again. And look at the delight there. They're that close to the championship.
Alan Tate, too. Should have scored a winner for Swansea at the end of the 90. Has to score here. Has to score here. Or Barnsley are up. The biggest kick of his life. It's Alan Tate. It's saved! Barnsley are in the championship. Colgan redeems himself for his earlier clangor. Richie has led them back into the big time in his first full season as a manager. And Alan Tate, who might have won it for Swansea at the end of the 90 minutes, has lost it for them in the penalty shootout. They are the pride of Yorkshire right now. They are Barnsley.
And the other players have to step up to the plate and be brave, and they did. It just wasn't their day.
Well, Barnsley, not so long ago, were a Premiership club. They left the second tier of English football behind 4 years ago. They are back. And Swansea will have to spend at least another season. Their prayers weren't answered today. They were unable to follow up the promotion from last season with another this season. You have to feel for Alan Tate, who should have won it. Glory was beckoning. The championship was beckoning at the end of 90 minutes for him. But he missed. And so did Lee Trundle in extra time, and Barnsley have won on penalties. And, well, Swansea could be proud, but Barnsley are having the time of their lives right now.
Yeah, you've got to feel sorry for Kenny Jackett and Swansea. They did have the better chances.
Very often, but they are days that will live long in the memory. Today's the day for Barnsley. Bring on the championship. They are promoted.